Hi everybody, I thought of making this video because many of you are practicing video lecture making now, and most of us are trying to use different tools for that. I also discovered one tool which is actually not used for video lecture making. It's Open Broadcaster software, which is usually used for live streaming, but I found that this tool which I use for live streaming can also be used for making video lectures. So if you are using some other tools and if you're comfortable with it, please go ahead with it. I just wanted to showcase one more tool which I found very useful, because all the previous video lectures which I made, where I overlaid my video over the PPT to make it more personal, I had to use two or three different tools to arrive at the result. But with this tool, I found that I could make the same thing with this one single tool. Rather than relying on two or three tools, I could make it all with this one single tool. So that was the advantage with this tool. So I would like to showcase how to use this tool called Open Broadcaster software for making video lectures. Now you can download this Open Broadcaster software from internet. If you search for OBS Studio, you'll find out the software, and please download the software according to your operating system, whether it's Windows, Linux or Mac OS. So download it, and installation process is pretty straightforward. And once you install the software, and if you open the OBS software, let's open this OBS software, you'll find the window something like this. Yeah, so there's a preview window, there's a program window, there's a source window, there's an audio mixer. Now for most of you, this option over here will be muted like this, but make sure that you unmute it. Can you see the audio level showing up? Yeah, that is the mic audio level. I would highly recommend that you connect a headset mic. If not a standalone mic, you connect a headset mic to your system or your laptop. Please do not use the open audio on your laptop. I would not recommend that because it captures a lot of noise. Even if it is a very quiet place, it captures a lot of ambient sound. So I would highly recommend use a headset microphone. Now, once you plug in and you see the level coming up, then you understand the audio levels are coming inside. Go to settings option. Before we start recording anything, go to settings option. And the settings option, the first option that you need to meddle with is the output segment. You need to know where your video is getting stored. So come to this recording option. And can you see this recording path? Yes. Click on this browse option. And you can now select the folder where your video should be stored. Now I have created this folder called Video Lectures, where I would like my videos to be stored after recording. Now after choosing the path, recording path, choose the recording quality. Now by default it will be same as stream, but I would suggest choose high quality, medium file size. Any one of these two you choose, it won't make a big difference, but I choose usually high quality, medium file size. When it comes to recording format, by default it will be MKV format. I would say choose MP4. Now once you made these three changes, rest of the two options just leave it like that, need not change it. Give apply. Once you have done with the output window, go to audio window. And by default the sample rate is 44.1 kHz, but I highly recommend that you choose the sample rate 48 kHz. This is in case if you do want to do any future edit, it is more comfortable to edit with 48 kHz than rather than 44.1 kHz. I'm not going into the technical detail of it. Click apply. Go to the video option next. And the video option, if you click, you'll find the base canvas resolution. Click on this slide window and you find out there are three different options. I recommend choose 1280x720. More than enough good quality is recorded in this way. It's a starting HD format, but ensure that your output resolution as well as base resolution is same. Now once you have done these changes, click apply again and give OK. Yeah. So once you give OK, it will ask you to restart the OBS Studio, which is quite normal. Restart it. Yeah. So once you restart your OBS window, now before you even go into recording or creating anything, ensure that you have opened all required PPTs or PDF files or Word files or anything that you want to show in the browser. All those files you open it and keep, so that it will be convenient for you to record the lecture. Because once you've started recording and you look for the any files, it will be difficult. So you can open any windows, whether it is a simulation software, a PPT, a Word file, PDF. Keep keep it open here so that you need not go and open the software again. Yeah. So I would recommend go to the PPT option, make it full screen. Once you've made it full screen, press Ctrl Alt Tab will give you this option of going to different screen. Now select the OBS Studio when the PPT is full screen. Now there is a reason I'm doing it, you'll understand later. Keep the PPT full screen and click the OBS Studio option. Now coming back to the OBS Studio, the first option after doing all the initial settings is a source window that you need to look into, and then come to this add option. Can you see this add option, this plus option? Now when you click on this plus option over here, you see a lot of different inputs that you can take. The first input that you need to take is to capture a display, that is capture a PPT or a Word file or a simulation software file and all those things. So I would suggest is you can either choose this display capture, which will capture everything that happens on the screen, or you can choose this Windows capture, which will allow you to choose individual windows, whether it is the browser window, whether it is the Word file, whether it's PPT file, individually. So as of now, let me go ahead with Windows capture option. So when I use the Windows capture option, click OK. Now when I choose this itself, you can see by default, it will showcase the PPT in the background. Yeah. Now if it does not come, can you see this window option over here? You can select different windows over here. Okay. I can choose lecture making window, or I can choose the PowerPoint window. So any of these windows, I can open it. And as per your requirement, you can open it. Okay. So once you have done this, give OK. Now your PPT has come. Now most of you would desire that in front of your PPT, your video also comes up. If you do not desire your video to come up, you can straight away go proceed and press record option over here and start recording. But the PPT is without a video, a picture in picture video, is pretty impersonal. So I would highly recommend that you embed your video over there. There is a way to do it. Now if you would like your video to come in the foreground, again go to this add option, click here on the add, and you'll be able to find out this video capture device option. Click on the video capture device, give OK. Now you would be able to see your video popping up. If you have a webcam integrated on your laptop, then automatically it will pick up this camera's feed. If not, you have to connect an external webcam to your laptop. So once you have done it, give OK. There's no other configuration setting you need to change. Give OK. And once you give OK, you will see this video being overlaid on it. Now right click on this red line and drag. Right click and drag. Now when you right click and drag, again click on that video and drag. Drag it to this particular corner or any corner of your choice. I prefer this corner. It's up to you to choose any corner. Now if you want to put some subtitles, if you again go to the add option over here and click the text option. Okay, and you can type the text required. Okay, video, for example, if I put video lecture making, and you can change the color of the text or as per your requirement. Yeah, so once you have done it, give OK. Again, you can resize it either on that same window or click on this red option and right click and drag it. Okay, right click and drag it. So achieve the size that you want. Okay, so you can achieve the size that you want, and you can overlay it. You can also use it to create watermarking. If you want to create some watermarking with your email ID or some information, you can do the same, and you can change even the opacity level of the text. You can again go to the properties, and maybe if you want to make the text opacity level, you want to reduce, then that is possible. Okay. So that you can use it as a watermark if you want. As you can see here, it appears like a watermark. Yes. Now, once that is done, if you want to add some logo and image, even that is possible. For example, you can go and add this Karunya University logo, which I have kept. If you want to add any other logo of your interest, which would serve the purpose over here, any image of your interest, you could serve the purpose here. You can overlay it. You can come and drag that image and drop into this source panel. It will appear in the window over here. Again, right click on the red line. Okay, you can place it as you want. Whenever you want to select an object and drag it, right click on the object and drag it. So once you have done this, now you can see over here, you have the logo, you have the video, you have the watermarking statement, and all these elements have been added. If you want to add any further thing, again go to the add option, and you can have a lot of other options. Okay, you can discover it. So for simplicity of this video, I'll keep it with only these four elements. Once you have done added all the required element, press on this transition option here. It will come to the program window. Till now we were in the preview window. Now it appears in the program window. Now anything that comes into the program window only will get recorded. Before you hit start recording, ensure that everything you have put in the preview window, you bring it to the program window. How do you do it? By clicking on this transition option. Now once you do that, now your program window has it. Now once it has come to the program window, click on the start recording option. Now after clicking on the start recording option, now if you want to start flipping through your PPT, or if you want to start check out in the simulation software tab, you're free to do so. Remember, use Control Alt Tab option. So don't directly go to that place by going through the mouse, because the capture can change. So I would recommend is use Control Alt Tab option and go to the screen of your choice. Now, for example, I want to go to the PowerPoint option. I go to the screen. Yes. Now, don't worry. Now you may not see a video appearing here, or a logo appearing here, or the watermark appearing here, but all of them are perfectly there. And once you have finished everything required, once you finished displaying your software, simulation software, or going through the Word or browser and all those things, once you have finished presenting your PPT, remember, press Control Alt Tab and go back to your Open Broadcaster software. Remember, use Control Alt Tab and then stop recording. Okay, click on stop recording and then this appears. Okay. So this is how you can record a simple video. Okay, so it's a very simple option, a straightforward option, and to add a video or a PPT and logo and all these thing elements and much more elements you can add using this one single tool, and that's why I highly recommend it. You can easily make video lectures using this tool. If there is any doubt, you can always get back to me. You can ask out, my contact details will be there in the description for the video. Thank you.